I know that everybody realizes the need and the issues that we have downtown with trucks. Just go down by the old historical courthouse, you know, on any given day, and you'll see what we're talking about down there. But as part of the NPO, we did a truck track, a truck route study for this area, and they came up with a few alternatives. The first being using Savannah Avenue. At one time, that was slated to be the truck route, was to rehab and improve Savannah Avenue. So they looked at two different alternatives for Savannah Avenue, which is leaving it as a two-lane section or possibly increasing it to a four-lane section. Then the second thing they looked at was coming just a little bit south of Savannah Avenue, which would, which you see there on your map, would come kind of just below the RDC and those areas down there. So that would be your second truck route that they were proposing. The next one was a south bypass, which was coming off of James Road. And this was, I mean, I guess if you think of it, this was kind of one of the things that I talked to them about a lot, because of the widening of Highway 133 from Albany all the way to Valdosta. You know, it's going to be a four-lane, five-lane section in some places coming all the way in. The amount of truck traffic that we're going to see on Highway 133 is fixing to increase astronomically. But if you're coming from Albany, instead of going, you know, 82 out to the interstate and then coming down the interstate to Valdosta, you're just going to shoot down 133, I would believe. The truckers will probably tell you that. So I think that's going to increase. And to you know, to keep those trucks from coming down St. Augustine Road through that long and narrow drive here, which we all already know is a nightmare to try to get through just about any time of the day. What I was recommending is, since we've already got a five-lane James Road that was built for a truck bypass, and we built it with 5 inches of asphalt, we anticipated the growth in that area. We built that thing with 5 inches of asphalt so we can handle whatever traffic we put on it. Coming down 133, coming down James Road, and then making that a bypass, and then at the end of James Road, when you get to Highway 84, you got the James Road extension that goes across, and then you take that James Road extension down and connect it back around to the south. So that was, you know, that was my thinking. That was kind of what I was had brought to the guys that were doing the bypass study, was to look at utilizing James Road, so we also keep those 133 trucks out of the mall area.
You will overpass the railroad there?
Yes, sir. I would think so. I think that's what we want to do. And then there's a south bypass, which uses St. Augustine Road. If you remember when the overpass was going on Highway 84, they used St. Augustine Road as a truck detour. They detoured all the trucks from around there. The biggest thing for that St. Augustine detour is you're going to have another overpass. You're going to have to come across those tracks there right on St. Augustine Road, just south of 84. That's a given. You're going to have to do that. And then the last one was a western perimeter, which, you know, really takes you way out, utilizes James Road, brings you down south of Indian Ford Road, and brings you back around to exit 11, coming out down to Hart Road, and then brings you back up Madison Highway to Perimeter Road. A long way around, but that opens up a lot of area and a lot of places to get around. Also, with that James Road bypass, you're also going to have a flyover over the interstate, that would be a basically, you know, a no egress, no egress, just a flyover with no ramps. And then the last one, I think, was, you know, kind of birthed out of the chamber, was the use of Gil Harbin, which is kind of an offspring of that the James Road area. But what they're doing is, instead of everything's coming down, and when they get to St. Augustine Road, the chamber was recommending using Gil Harbin to take it across over to Statenville HWY instead of you know, building a new road through there. And with both the Gil Harbin and the James Road bypass, one of the biggest issues I think we'll face politically in bringing that road where they've got located out right now is bringing down Lloyd Jackson. So you know how those folks out there have for years and years tried to fight that development out there with the industrial authority, and it's, you know, this is where everybody's rejecting that road to come through, is right there at Lloyd Jackson.
Does property owners get assurance and approvals for that road never be used for anything other than that surface track?
That's right. Yeah, that's a pretty big undertaking there. It's basically, you have to look at the whole picture, but you would be taking a four-lane highway, I'm assuming four-lane,
yes,
right in the middle of the neighborhood.
On St. Augustine, crossing the tracks there with the overpass,
yes,
you're going to have super elevation, I assume, on both sides. Each lane,
right,
two lanes on either side, because you don't have enough distance from the track back to 84 to drop down.
That's correct.
Which is expensive.
That's right.
And it is similar to the latest 84 overpass, right?
That's right.
It's a much longer time.
That's right.
To you. But you're saying it has to come back on the other side of 84. So you're saying just the length to the point.
Yeah.
I think that whenever it's all said and done, I think that coming over that railroad track would take you all the way across 84. And then if you want to go on 84, you basically have an off ramp that you would circle back around and get back on the 84. Because you just can't get down. You can't, the grade doesn't work.
Yeah, you'd be backed up, stop traffic at that intersection right there. People topping that bridge.
It would be a, our version of spaghetti jumps.
Yeah. That's what I think you would end up seeing is you would actually go over 84 as well, and then you'd have kind of cloverleaf back around to get you back to 84 if that's the way you want to go. Or you could potentially come off before and go across the railroad tracks and then 84 if that's what you get there, here's Savannah Ave or something like that.
That's what we showed before, a couple years ago, the actual entertainment bridge for it.
Yes, it'll be a massive structure.
Mike, and help me with this, but if I understand this correctly, based on what I've been hearing from different groups, right now the plan, you might say, that Chamber has embraced,
right,
the downtown development folks down there, they've embraced, as well as, to some degree, the GDOT has embraced, is the Gil Harbin alternative.
Now, I don't know that DOT has embraced it.
Okay.
I do not know that.
Okay.
I don't know where DOT stands on it, because DOT has all the factors that they have, you know, distance, time, stops, all those things that, you know, you have to, you go into account for as far as whether they're making a truck route or not. So I have not officially heard anything from the DOT.
They recently, with the overpass.
Right.
That's in existence. That was designated as the truck route.
That's right.
For that purpose and intent.
Right.
So when the DOT board was here and this issue was discussed with the commissioner, he had a little bit of reservations to, we just spent X number of dollars on an overpass to improve it for the truck.
Right.
Because the issue was made, the trucks can't get through because of the train. We put an overpass in, okay, now let's move it somewhere else. And he was a little, wasn't against it, but he was saying it's a problem.
That's right.
Of finding another truck route, and you just asked us to use state and federal highway funds to build this overpass.
So let's build an overpass. You know
how much was it?
Yeah, how much was the overpass?
It was 9 million.
Yeah, I was going to say 8 million. I was going to say between 8 and 9.
I think the one that Mike's talking about today at St. Augustine will be more than that.
Yeah, and that 17 million or almost $18 million in construction, I believe probably 12 or 13 of that is going to be just in that overpass.
Mike, let me, and just for a point of discussion. If that western perimeter,
yes, sir.
If you to shorten that up, you come right at the end of the perimeter road, which is right there then south of the airport, and I'm not 100% sure based on this map of what distance you are from the runway and those sort of things at that point where the perimeter road comes out.
Right.
Be there about between the end of somewhere in the airport property and the Carroll property.
Yes, sir.
Go straight across right there.
And the Carroll property, that
all the Carroll property or
racetrack road?
Yeah, well, basically, really just the extended perimeter road right on across Madison Highway. And then connect it over there to a flyover at the interstate and be south of exit 13.
Right.
And then connect your Indian Ford Road and back over that way. If you take out that big dog leg, you might say, that is your all the way up to exit 11.
I think the issue down there is at the south end of that runway. And I think the way that it lines up, you'd be clipping at the south end of that runway.
Well, you know, I've always thought, I said, you know, so, well, they said, well, you're right at the end of the runway. But, you know, I go through Atlanta, and I'm right at the end of the runway of all the tennis track. I mean, the planes are not going to sit down on top of it. We're not talking about small planes, we're talking about big heads. So, and we all talk about it, we got one of the longest runways in the state, I believe, that's there at that airport as it is.
Third
longest runways. So I know you're coming way down the road, the potential where you could be broke that with the airport, but I've just always thought about it. You know, perimeter road was built years ago, and I'm not going to say it's a bad idea, but I thought it was a great idea at the time. But because it wasn't a true bypass, as it should have been, it never got completed. It now development and all around it, it really taken away the usefulness of it.
That's right.
I mean, if trucks come and go around east, I mean, go south or go north, that chose to, certainly on the north side of the road, all that is developed now, and that's a busy area out there around Oak Street. So thinking that you can take trucks down through there, you really, that's impossible. But reality is that from a true bypass, if we could utilize a large portion of perimeter road for what its original intent was, and try to loop it in that way. I know that with GDOT, they have a big deal with added distance for trucks to drive. They need less stops, rail crossings, and there's a lot of things that they take a look at. And if I understand the conversations that I have had with them, is that before you can change a state route, a designated state route that has to go through basically a national board. And they review all those factors, such as how many stops, the distance of the route itself. It has to be approved by them just so you can change the designation of 84 to take that truck route.
That's correct.
Would that be correct? That's right.
And they look at the number of stops, they look at the length, and they look at the time.
And time, right. So I don't know if going perimeter road would meet their guidelines, because it certainly is going to be longer, but there's a good possibility that it might be on the timeline, it might be quicker.
Probably would have been a lot quicker if they had to build overpass.
Right.
I mean, you got to shot us up in the foot, that's right. A build overpass, make the trucks go through quicker than...
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Ridge point, now we have to change even further out. That's why I kind of like that James Over talking about going further to the south, what happened to that.
I think the ideal place to tie that one in, just like you're talking about, to come down is being before, whether you utilize the perimeter road that western, you're utilizing coming into that intersection of James Road, and that allows those trucks to stay. They want to go to the 133 route, they want to go 84. They're free to go in the way, right? Right there, right.
But the biggest issue I see with that James Road deal is Lloyd Jackson.
Yeah,
I mean that'll be
with the Gil Harbin.
Oh, well, the one for Gil Harbin and James Road bypass both utilize Lloyd Jackson. Both of them utilize that. The South bypass using James Road,
okay.
and the Gil Harbin, both of them utilize Lloyd Jackson.
Okay.
And that's the biggest issue I see with those two.
But then the western perimeter, though, still utilizes James Road.
That's right. Yes.
Yeah. I mean, you still would utilize James Road, which is just not designated.
And if you bring it down to that block in an area where kind of they've got the sewer area, water sewer number three, and bring it down there to the far end of Indian Fold.
Right.
Yes.
Well, one thing to remember, I'm sure you will, this is a community project.
Absolutely.
But obtaining the right-of-way and dealing with the citizens is going to fall on the county commissioners. That area is the one that will be most impacted. From the negative impression of property owners.
If you do the western perimeter, like what we're talking about, 100% of that is in the county. 100% of that road is in the county.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, let me just say this. I thought a lot about this. I haven't really spoken to anybody that says that trucks in downtown Valdosta is not an issue. Everybody believes that it is a problem. I think it's important that before we just embrace a specific route, I think it's important that we still have the time to sit down and really develop a good, positive route that will work for the growth of Valdosta. That, to give you an example, the Savannah Avenue route would more like a temporary deal. You're still not getting the trucks out of Valdosta, you're just moving them a little bit further south. So you're really not accomplishing anything. So the route that you need to take needs to be something that eventually is going to be a true route around downtown Valdosta to get it out of town. And those things also, history has shown that over the years, they also spur development as you move along. There is some development that happens along. It brings up a couple of things that we'll get into some more discussion on. But the one thing that I think that has come up, or I believe it's come up, that we're going to need to consider, and that is that we've been approached by the Chambers Transfer Transportation Committee to do a resolution in support of the truck bypass, or truck bypass in order to get the trucks out of downtown Valdosta. Now, from my point of view, where I'm at with it, I think that we need to be careful about how we, if we choose to do that, we just need to be careful about how we draft the resolution. I am in support, which I think most everybody else is, about looking at a way to get the trucks out of downtown. But I'm not ready, as a chairman, to commit to a specific route at this time. I think that we're a long way away from determining what that ultimate route needs to be. So what I would like to see as we move forward would be the commissioners to consider and study a resolution in support of this truck route. But again, we just need to be careful about how that wording is done. But I do believe that we need to begin to look at that issue.
I think that's scheduled.
Thank you. We're getting it there. Any discussion on that before we move into more? Mark?
Is a resolution like a non-binding agreement? As an ordinance would be a lot stronger.
An ordinance?
Yeah.
You would need an ordinance.
I know that. I'm saying a resolution is like a non-binding agreement.
Basically, what a resolution is that you just resolve to support the idea of moving the trucks out of downtown Valdosta. To me, that's about as
a commitment.
To support it?
It's a commitment to support whatever the text of the resolution says.
That's
so it is not binding as far as everyone can see over it and don't do it. But it is a plan, or not a plan, depending on how we draft.
Yeah. And again, that's the reason I say it needs to be drafted properly. Not to make it that it's not non-binding, but to make it to the point that we're not specific about choosing what the route is, but that we support
a plan.
Idea, the plan, plan of moving the trucks out of downtown.
Are they pushing this resolution?
They basically, when you say pushing, the committee has approached the county and have asked that we support through the form of a resolution of the downtown bypass.
The development authority has formally adopted a resolution that includes a plan that they forwarded to us to ask the commission to consider. And I think it's someone else in the city about it.
The city has not been aware of that.
It sounds like another one of those bureaucratic bull jive things where we write a resolution to think about a resolution, to have a plan.
I'll use their analogy.
There's no plan, there's no.
Yeah, I'll use their analogy. There's their idea of getting the support from the standpoint of a resolution that local governments and the community, other development authorities and other folks that support the idea of the bypass will give a little bit more leverage to the idea with GDOT to also embrace the part.
They just have the people who are going to write the check.
You're talking about anywhere from, I mean, you could be $60, $65, $70 million pretty easy to build a truck bypass. We're not talking about something that's going to be cheap, but certainly the hopes would be is that you maybe can get 80%, I'm just speculating, 80% of, you know, Department of Transportation, the Fed building some, and then county would have to come up with the remainder, because as you say, to a point there's 100% of it. Now, on this issue, there are some other things we can discuss in regards to that we'll get into, but the idea is basically is to support the plan of developing a downtown truck bypass. And I think that that's proved out about it. Basically, we need to get it. Everybody take a look at that. That is one thing that we need to consider